All the way down the line.
This is a free country, ain't it?
Buying toys?
What people?
Joe, You're always making me do crazy things for you, and now I'm the guy that's getting embarrassed. Just sit in this place and make me do all the dirty work.
Just do what I tell you.
Okay, but I wish I knew why.
Hey, wait a minute. Here's a nickel. One to photograph. Number 7, I want to hear that waltz again.
Boy, I'm glad I don't have to stay and listen to that song. What do you mean that song anyway, Joe? We listen to it 10 times a day. Why can't we listen to number 2, or 6, or 9? There's a lot of other numbers.
Put this nickel in the photograph. Sit down, wait till the music starts, and then go get me those folks.
Great.
Never mind being a martyr about it either. Cause ain't working. Some instructions.
What do you want, Joe?
I want you to come to your senses.
Hey, Joe, hey, I got it. The emporium, the airport, the back, the toy department. $2 worth of toy that he can put on the table.
Who the hell is he to push a big man like that around?
I'll expect you in half an hour. Don't get sidetracked anywhere. Just do what I tell you.
Joe, can't I bet 4 bits on a horse race? There's a long shot, precious time. That's about to win by 2 lengths. Got to have some money, Joe.
I thought you wanted him to get you a watermelon.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Say, what's the dream?
What?
What's the dream now?
What dream?
What dream? The dream you're dreaming.
Suppose he did bring you a watermelon. What on earth would you do with it?
I'd put it on the table, I'd look at it, and I'd eat it. What do you think I was going to do with it? Sell it for profit?
How should I know what you'd do with anything? What I'd like to know is, what kind of work do you do and how do you make your money?
Bring us a bottle of champagne.
Champagne?
Would you rather have something else?
All right, what's the big idea?
Nothing, I just thought you might like some champagne. I myself am very fond of it.
Yeah. But what's the big idea? You can't push me around.
It's not in my nature to be unkind to another human being.
Be careful what you think of me.
I have only the noblest thoughts for both your person and your spirit.
What on earth are you talking about?
You shut up!
She owns this place. She's an important woman. All kinds of people come to her looking for work. Comedians, singers, dancers.
I don't care. She can't call me names.
Boy, sister. I know how it is at $2 whore in the morning.
Don't you dare call me names. I used to be in burlesque.
If you were ever in burlesque, I used to be Charlie Chaplin.
But I was in burlesque. I played the burlesque circuit from coast to coast. I've had flowers sent to me by European royalty. And I've had dinner with young men of wealth and social position.
You're dreaming.
I really wasn't burlesque. Kitty Duval, that was my name. Life-size photographs of me in costume in front of burlesque theaters all over the country.
I believe you. Please, just have some champagne.
There he goes again.
Miss Duval, is it?
Well, that's not my real name. It's my stage name.
I'll call you by your stage name then.
All right, sir. or not?
Just pour the lady some wine.
Okay, Professor. Why come to this place instead of one of the high-class dumps uptown? I won't ever understand. Why don't you have champagne at the St. Francis? Why don't you drink with a lady?
Don't you dare call me names, you dentist.
What sort of cousin is that? This guy doesn't belong here. The only reason I've got champagne is because he keeps ordering it all the time. And don't think you're the only one he drinks with. He drinks with all of them. He's crazy or something.
Nick, I think you should be all right. Just in a couple of centuries.
I'm sorry, I don't understand your English.
To the spirit, please, Ma.
Thank you.
Hey, Nick.
Yeah?
Mind putting a nick on the phonograph? Number
seven. I know. I don't mind at all, Your Highness. Though personally, I'm not a lover of music. It gets everybody worked up. Gives everybody stuff they should have.
I just put the damn nick on the phonograph.
Oh, I like champagne. And everything that goes with it. Big houses with big porches. And big rooms with big windows. And big lawns and big trees. And flowers growing everywhere. And big shepherd dogs sleeping in the shade.
I'm going next door to Frankie's to make a bet.
Oh, make one for me.
Yeah? Who do you like?
Precious Time.
$10 across the port.
Nope, on the nose.
Sunset. 7749. Yes. Sunset 7943. Well, what's your name? Lorenzi. I thought you were Elsie Mandel's. Oh, what? There's a lot of noise around here. What? Dacia. Yeah, Dacia are bossed with. Yeah, it stands for Brown. But I never said that. Where am I? At Nick's on Pacific Street. I work at the SBI. I told them I was sick and they gave me the afternoon off. Yeah, sure, I'm pleased to meet you too. Yeah, Alaska.
Number 5 Pacific Street, you cad.
Cad?
Yeah.
You don't know how I've been suffering on account of Elsie. I take things too seriously, and I've got to be more like a daisy. Hello, Eleanor. Lorraine? It's number 2 Pacific Street. Yeah, sure. How do you know me? You know me, and I recognize.
I'm standing there. I didn't do anything to anybody. Why should I be a soldier?
What?
Okay.
What?
I retreat. I hate war. I'm the second.
Why come in and lay off for a minute?
Nobody's got the sense of humor anymore. The world is dying for comedy like that every part, but nobody knows how to laugh.
Do you belong to the union?
What union?
For the love of Mike, where have you been? Don't you know you can't walk into a place and ask for a job and get to work just like that? You've got to belong to one of the unions.
I didn't know. I've got to have a job real soon.
Well, you've got to belong to a union.
I don't want any favors. All I want is a chance to earn a living.
All right. Go into the kitchen. Ask Sam to give you some supper.
What is Sam talking?
Well, I've got to for Elsie.
I have all kinds of funny ideas in my head to make the world happy again. See if you think this is funny. It's my own idea. I created this desk myself. It's come after the monologue.
Gee, Elsie, what the hell do I want to see? Lorraine sweet for some girl I don't know.
I dream of home. Christ, I always dream of home. I've no home, I've no place. But I always dream of all of us together again. We had a farm in Ohio. There was nothing good about it. It was always sad. There was always trouble, but I don't know. I just dream about it as if I could go back and Papa would be there, and Mama, and Louie, and my brother Stephen, and my sister Mary. I'm Polish. Duval. My name isn't Duval, it's Koronowski. Katerina Koronowski. We lost everything. The house, the farm, the horses, the cows, the chickens, the trees. Papa died. He was old. He was 13 years older than Mama. So we moved to Chicago. We tried to work. We tried to stay together, but then Louie got in trouble. The fellows he was with killed him for some reason. I don't know what. And then Stephen ran away from home, 17 years old. I don't know where he is. And then Mama died. What's the dream? I dream of home.
I didn't know I was that hungry.
Hey, what the hell do you think you're doing?
That's my own idea! I'm a natural born dancer and comedian!
No good. What do you want to be a comedian for? Why don't you get a different job at a store selling something?
I've got something for the work, but they haven't got sense enough to let me give it to them. Nobody knows me.
Elsie, now I'm waiting for some dame I've never seen before. Lorraine Smith. I just happened to get the wrong number. And she turns on the personality. And I'm a cooked Indian. Give me a beer.
Nick, you've got to see my act. It's the greatest thing of its kind in America. All I need is a chance, no salary to begin. And if I don't wow it, okay, I will go home. If Bob Will wasn't dead, a girl like me would have a chance.
You're not funny. You're a sad young punk. What do you want to try to be funny about? You'll break everybody's heart. What is there for you to be funny about? You've been poor all your life, haven't you?
I've been poor, all right. But don't forget that some things count more than some other things.
What, for instance, counts more than what, for instance?
Talent, for instance, counts more than money, for instance. That's right, and I've got talent. I get new ideas night and day. Everything's come natural to me. I've got this diet, but it will take a little time to round it up. That's it.
I run the loudest dive in Frisco, and a man walks in and makes me stock up on champagne. The whores come in and holler at me that they're ladies. Talent comes in and begs me for a chance. Even society people come in here once in a while. I don't know what for. Maybe it's the location, maybe it's the liquor, maybe it's my personality or the crazy personality of the joint, the old honky-tonk. Maybe they just can't feel at home anywhere else.
He said to tell her not to wait.
Well,
What do you want?
I just want you to know that it's gonna stop.
People come in here to drink and loaf around. I don't care who they are.
Well, I do.
The only way to tell if a woman is a street walker is to walk the streets with her, go to bed, and make sure. You wouldn't want to do that. You'd like to, of course.
Any woman will have her joint closed!
Listen, I've got no use for you or anybody like you. You have to change the world from something bad to something worse. Something like yourself.
I'll be back tonight.
Do yourself a big favor and don't come back tonight. Send somebody else. I don't like your personality.
Don't break any laws. I don't like yours either.
Nick, you're gonna kill that woman.
I'm disgusted.
Yeah? Why?
Why should I get worked up over a woman like that? Why should I hate her? She's nobody. She's nothing. She's a mouse. But every time she walks in here, I get burned up. She doesn't want to drink, she doesn't want to sit down, she doesn't want to take things easy for a while. So give me one thing.
Do my best.
What's a punk like that want to change the world for?
Does she want to change the world?
You know what I mean. What does she want to bother people for? It's sick.
I guess she wants to change the world at that.
So I go to work and I hate her.
It's not her, Nick, it's everything.
Yeah, I know, but I've still got no use for her. She hurts little people. One of the girls tried to commit suicide because of her. I'll break her head if she hurts anybody around here. Or anybody's feelings, either.
She might not be so bad deep down underneath.
I know everything about her. She's sick. Got a good joint here, there's nothing wrong. Hey, comedian, I think the dancing is all right.
Shit, sneak! Gosh! I'm on my way for this! Hello? Ma? Is that you, Ma? It's Harry! I got the job!
Partially correct. Joseph's my first name, but everybody calls me both sides. You know, Mary's one of my favorite names. I met a girl in Mexico City named Mary once. She was an American from Philadelphia. And she got married there in Mexico City while I was there. And we were in love, Mark, or at least I was. You never know about anyone else. They were already engaged and her mother was with her, so they went through with it. Must have been 7 or 8 years ago. Probably have 3 kids by now.
Are you still in love with her?
No. I don't know, I guess I am. I didn't even know she was engaged until a couple of days before the wedding. Thought I was gonna marry her. Kept thinking a long time about the kinds of kids we were likely to have. The first two were fine, you know, they were handsome and intelligent, but the third one was different. He was dumb and goofy looking. I liked him a lot, so when she told me she was getting married, I didn't feel so bad about the first. It was that dumb one.
What do you do?
Do, to tell you the truth, absolutely nothing.
Do you always drink a great deal?
No, not always. Only when I'm away. And I sleep 7 or 8 hours every night.
How nice. I mean, to drink when you are awake.
It's a privilege.
But do you really like to drink?
As much as I like to drink.
What?
Why do I like to drink? Because I don't like to be jit. Because I don't like to be dead all the time and a little alive once every long while. If I don't drink, I become fascinated with unimportant things like everyone else. I get busy. I do things. Now I don't do anything. I live all the time. And then I go to sleep.
Do you sleep well?
Yeah, of course.
What are your plans?
Plans? I haven't got any.
Oh, yes, yes, of course.
I just get up. Why do I like to drink? You know, that question calls for a pretty complicated answer.
Oh, I didn't mean to.
No. I insist. I know why. It's just a matter of finding the right words, the little words.
It really doesn't matter.
Yes, it does. Yes, it does. Now, why do I like to drink? No, why does anybody like to drink? Every day has 24 hours.
Yes, that's true.
24. And out of those 24, at least 23 and a half are just minutes on the clock, not time of life. Doesn't matter who you are, doesn't matter what you do, 23 and a half out of those 24 are spent waiting.
Waiting.
And the longer you wait, the less there is to wait for. Before you know it, all the minutes are dead, all the weeks are dead, all the years are dead, you yourself are dead. There's nothing left to wait for, nothing but minutes on the clock, not the time of life. Does that answer your question?
I'm afraid it does. Thank you, you shouldn't have gone to all the trouble.
No trouble at all. You have kids?
Yes. Two. A son and a daughter.
How small do they look like?
Yes.
Then why are you sad?
I was always sad. It's just that after I was married, I was allowed to drink.
Who are you waiting for?
No one.
I'm not waiting for anyone either.
My husband, of course.
Yeah, sure.
He's a lawyer.
He's a great guy. I like him. I'm very fond of him.
You have responsibility.
1 in 1,000. In fact, I feel responsible for everybody I know. See, for 2 years now, I've been trying to find out if it's possible to live what I think is a civilized life. I mean, a life that can't hurt any other life. Would you like to dance?
All right.
I'm sorry I don't dance.
To tell you the truth, I don't like to dance at all.
Hardly walk.
You're
you do our sex?
No, I mean all the time.
Where do you ever eat parents?
In 1928 and 1934.
What month of 1934?
Most of April, all of May, and a little of June.
I was there in November and December that year.
We were almost at the same time. You were married?
Indeed. Are you really in love with me?
Yeah.
Is it the champagne?
Yeah, partly.
If you don't see me again, will you be very unhappy?
Very.
I'm so pleased. I can go now. Please don't get up.
The right of the inferior.
The who?
the interior, the world full of mechanics who haven't got what it takes to make monkeys out of everybody nearby. The men who were created equal, remember?
But Matt, you're not inferior.
I'm a worker and an idealist. I married a small sensitive cultured woman so my kids would be sisters, not suckers. God, the Salin High School is thinking of being a writer.
I wanted to be a writer once.
Wonderful.
They all wanted to be writers. Every maniac in the world who ever wrote about the murder of people through war started in an attic or basement writing poetry. And it's stand, so they got even by becoming important heels. And it's still going on.
But is this really, Joe?
Look at today's papers.
Right now, in Colorville is some punk who's trying to be Shakespeare. 10 years from now, I'll be a senator or a communist.
But then somebody had to do something about it.
The thing to do is to have more magazines, hundreds of them, thousands. Print everything they write, so they believe they're immortal. That way, keep them from going haywire.
Matt, you have to be a writer yourself.
I hate to try. They're mischief makers, right?
Right.
Then why do you read?
Well, it's relaxing. It's soothing. Don't get me wrong, language is all right. It's the people who use language that are lousy. What do you think, brother?
No foundation. All the way down the line. What? What not? Nothing. I'll go walk and look in the sky.
What? What not? What's that?
What? What not? That means this side, that side. Inhale, exhale. What birth? What not death? That man is, in his own way, a prophet. He is one who, with the help of beer, is able to reach that deep state of understanding in which what not, the reasonable and the unreasonable, are one.
Right.
If you can understand that kind of talk, how can you be a longshore man?
Well, I come from the long line of McCarthy's, who never married or slept with anything but the most powerful and quarrelsome flesh.
I can listen to you guys talk for hours, but I'll be damned if I know what the hell you're talking about.
Consequences. All the McCarthy's are too brave, too strong to be heroes. Only the weak and unsure perform the hero. They've got to. The more heroes you have, the worse the history of the world becomes.
You sure can, the philosopher. Well, you can talk.
I wouldn't talk this way to anybody but the man in uniform and the man who wouldn't understand a single word of what I was saying. The part I'm speaking of, my friend, is you.
Hear, hear! What do you think you're doing?
I just got an idea for a new dance. I'm trying it out. Make the pause for Indy. Has she got the right to do that?
Well, the lady have danced from the beginning of time. I might even say that the dance and the life have moved along together until now we have. Go into your dance key. Show us what we have.
I haven't worked it out completely yet, but it starts out like this.
Nix Entertainment Palace and Saloon, Nix speaking. How may I help you? Is it Dudley Bosbeck at the door?
Hello. Oh, hello, Elsie. You're coming down?
She's
coming down. Oh, Elsie. No, I won't drink, I promise you.
Oh, gosh, Elsie.
Splendid.
Dad, I go into this little routine.
Is that good enough?
It's awful. It's honest and ambitious, like everything else in this great country.
And then I worked up only 2 days.
Excellent.
And this is where I really get going!
Excellent. A most satisfying demonstration of the present soul of the American, of the present state of the soul of American body.
I'm going home in front of the audience for the first time in my life tonight.
They'll be delighted. Where did you learn to dance?
Never took a lesson in my life. I'm natural born dancer. And comedian too.
You can make people laugh.
I can be funny, but they won't laugh.
That's odd. Why not?
I don't know. They
Would you care to be funny now?
I would like to try out the new model that I've been thinking about.
Then please do. And if it is funny, I promise I shall roar with laughter.
This is it! I'm up and shining on Turk Street. It's going to last. Daylight savings. What I have is a headache and a 1918 liquor. What I want is a cup of coffee. If I buy a cup of coffee with the liquor, I've got to walk home. I've got an equal problem. George the Greek is shooting a game of snooker with Pedro the Filipino. And the Reds, they're wearing $35 suit made to order. I don't have a cigarette. They're smoking Bobby Bird Panatellas. I'm thinking it over like I always do. George the Greek is in a tough spot. He takes the cue, chucks it, studies the table, touches the keyboard and take. What happens? He makes the three ball. What do I do? I get confused. I go out and buy a morning paper. Thursday, the crowd. Maybe the headline is not me. I take a quick look.
Organic will cure itself. If it ain't organic, science will cure it. What is it, organic or non-organic?
No, Joe.
What's he eating you? Hey, I want you to go out on an errand for me.
It's Kitty.
What about her?
She's up in her room crying.
Crying?
Yeah, she's been crying for over an hour.
What's she crying about?
I don't know. I'm talking to her all this time, but I couldn't understand the thing. She kept crying and telling me about a big house. Holly dog and flowers all around. One of the brothers dead, another lost somewhere. Joe, I just can't stop crying.
You want to marry the girl?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know exactly why, Joe. Joe, I just don't like to play with Kitty out in the streets like that. I guess I love her, that's all.
She is a nice girl.
She's like an angel. Like these other street walkers.
Take this money, run next door to Frankie's, and bet it all on the nose of McCarthy.
McCarthy, all this money, Joe?
Yeah,
Eric. Oh, Joe, McCarthy wins, we'll be rich.
Keep going.
No foundation!
No foundation. All the way down the line.
McCarthy, just because you got a bit lucky this morning, you have to go to work and throw away $80.
Wants to marry him, though.
Suppose she doesn't want to marry him?
Oh, yeah? Now, why would Kitty not want to marry a nice guy like Tom?
She's been in burlesque. She's dined with young men of social position. She's had flowers sent to her by European royalty. She's above Tom.
They were running when I got there. Frank wouldn't take a bet. Our horse didn't get caught in the stretch. I thought we were going to save all that money and then win by 2 inches.
Would he pay 15 to 1?
Better, but Frank wouldn't take the bet.
For the love of Mike!
Give me the money.
It's about $1,500, Joe.
All right. Go to Schwabacher and Frey and buy me the biggest red magnolia map of the nations of Europe you can find. On your way back, stop at one of the pawn shops on 3rd Street and buy me a good revolver and some cartridges.
He's up in the room crying, Joe.
Don't get me those things.
What are you going to do? Study the map? And then go outside and shoot somebody?
I want to read the names of some of Europe's towns and rivers and valleys and mountains.
What do you want with the revolver?
I want to study it. I'm interested in things. Get going.
Big map of Europe and the pole.
Yeah, get a good one. Tell the man you don't know anything about guns and you're trusting him not to fool you. Don't pay more than $10.
Joe, why do you send me out for crazy things all the time?
I'm not crazy, now get going.
What about Kitty, Joe?
Let her try to do her bit.
She comes in here while I'm gone. Talk to her, Joe, will you? Tell her about me.
All right, get going. Don't load the gun on the way, just buy it and bring it here.
You won't catch me loading any gun?
Take these toys away, by the way.
I like it. Well, I think you do.
I don't know. Give them to some kid. Better yet, take him up to Kitty.
Shall I do it? Take him up to Kitty?
Yeah, why not? Toy stopped me from crying once. That's what I'm looking for. That's why I had to buy it. I want to see why they stopped me from crying.
Yeah, sure, Joe. I'll take him up to Kitty. Nice little girl.
Misty, can I play the piano again?
Yeah, sure, until I tell you to stop.
You're going to pay me for playing the piano?
Yeah, all right. I'll give you enough to get by on.
Getting paid for playing the piano?
What are you crying about?
My mother.
What about her?
Dead. Stop crying when they drop me in the toilet. Murphy's the name. Just an old traveler. Mind if I sit down?
Be the light of all you drink.
Beer? Simmons, I've been drinking. Thanks.
Glass of beer, Nick.
Came to blows. Me and Henry Walton.
bashed his head with a brass cuspidor and ran away to Mexico. Took up with the cattle breeder named Diego, said, "Your job, Murphy, is to feed the dry food." I said, "Fine, what'll I feed them?" Said, "Hey, lettuce, sausage, beer, that's right." Came to blows 2 days later over an accordion he claimed I stole.
Did you?
I borrowed it. During the fight, I busted it over his head. Ruined one of the finest accordions I ever saw. Grabbed the horse and rode back across the border, Texas. Got to talking with the fellow who looked honest. He turned out to be a ranger who was looking for me.
You were saying a 30-minute conversation.
Will I ever forget that lady? Will I ever get over that Amazon or
ocean? No, will you?
If I live to be 60, 60!
You look more than 60 now.
That's trouble showing in my face. Trouble and complications. I was 58 3 months ago.
That's a tough story. Go ahead, tell me more.
Called the Texas Ranger, my name was Rochdale. Mining engineer from Pennsylvania. Looking for something worthwhile. Mentioned two places in Houston. Nearly lost an eye one morning going down the stairs. Ran into a six-footer with an iron claw. Where his right hand was supposed to be. Said, "You broke up my bow." Told him I was a stranger in Houston. The girls gathered at the top of the stairs to see the fight. Seven of them. 6 feet and an iron claw. That's bad on the nerves. Beat him in the mouth when he's hung from my hand with the claw. Would have lost an eye except for quick thinking. Crawled into the gutter and pulled the gun. Fired 7 times. I was back upstairs. Left the place an hour later, dressed in silk and in pants. Saw him standing in the corner, waiting. Said,
"Care for a wiggle?"
Said he didn't. Going up down the street and left town. I don't suppose you ever had to put a dress on to save your skin. Did you?
No, and I never fell in love with a midget weighing 39 pounds. You have some more?
Thanks. Ever tried to herd cattle on a bicycle?
No, never got around to that. Where did you herd cattle on a bicycle?
Toledo, Ohio, 1918.
Toledo? They don't herd cattle in Toledo.
They don't anymore. They did in 1918. One fellow did least race, bookkeeper named Sam Gall. Straight from the east side, New York. Sombrero, lariats, 2 herd of cattle and 2 bicycles. Called this place the Gold Bar Ranch. 2 acres, just outside the city limits. That was the year of the war. You remember?
Yeah, I remember. But what about herding them cattle on a bicycle? How'd you manage that?
Easiest thing in the world. Rode no head. Had to, otherwise couldn't last all the cows. Worked for Sam Gold till the cows ran away. Bicycles scared them. They went to Toledo. Never so high nor hair of him again. Broke his heart. Sold both bikes and returned to New York. Took 4 aces from a deck of red cards and walked to town. Poker. Fellow in the game named Chuck Collins, liked to gamble. Called him with a smile. I didn't suppose he'd care to bet $100. I would hold 4 aces in the next hand.
Did he?
Caught! My cards were red on the blank side. The other cards were blue.
Oh.
Plum forgot all about it. Showed him 4 aces. Ace of spades, ace of clubs, ace of diamonds, and ace of hearts. I'll remember them cards if I live to be 60. Would have been killed on the spot. Except for the hurricane that year. You haven't forgotten the Toledo hurricane from 1918, have you?
No, wait, no, there was no hurricane in 1918. Or any other year for that matter.
For the love of God,
Then what do you suppose that commotion was? And how come I came in Chicago dream down the state street?
I guess they just scared you.
No, that wasn't it. You go back to the papers of November 1918 and I'm sure you'll find there was a hurricane in Toledo. I remember sitting on the roof of a two-story house floating northwest.
Northwest.
Now, son, don't tell me you don't believe me either.
Of course I believe. Living is an art, not a bookkeeping. It takes a lot of rehearsal for a man to get to be himself.
Son, you're the first man I've ever met who believes me.
Have another beer on me.
Thanks.
Did you give her the toys?
Yeah, I gave her.
Did she stop crying?
No, she cried harder than ever.
I wonder why.
You know, if I was a minute, Frank would have taken the bet. He would have had about $1,500 by now. How much of it would you have given me, Joe?
If she'd marry her? All of it.
Would you do it?
Sure. In this realm, there's only one subject, and you're it, Tom. And it's my duty to see that my subjects are happy.
Joe, do you think we'll ever have any dolls for a race sometime soon that we like? When there's a 15-to-1 shot, weather good, track fast, they get off to a good start. Our horse does not get a cold to the stretch. We think we're going to lose all that money at the win. Why, you know?
I didn't get that.
You know what I mean, Joe?
What do you mean is the impossible? No, Tom, we were just a little late, that's all.
How am I ever going to make enough money to marry the girl?
I don't know, Tom. Maybe you won't.
Sure. I got to marry Kitty. Got to see the crazy room she lives in.
Sorry, we're missing.
Bad Joe. It's tiny. Crowds you in. Okay, don't belong in a place like that.
You want to take her out of it?
Yeah, sure. Can you have to have a garden or something?
You want to take care of her?
Yeah, sure. I'll take care of somebody because that makes me feel like I'm somebody.
That means you'll have to get a job. What can you do?
I graduated high school, but I don't know what I can do.
Sometimes when you think about it, what do you think you'd like to do?
I'll sit around like you, Joe, and have somebody on errands for me, and never be broke, and never worry about money again.
That's a noble ambition.
How do you do it?
You know, I really don't know, but I think you have to have the full cooperation of the good Lord.
I can't understand the way you talk.
Joe, can I go up and see if I can get Kate to stop crying?
Give me a hand and I'll call you.
What? Joe, I've seen this in one place from 4 in the morning to 2 in the next.
My best, Tom. I don't travel like that. Come on, give me a hand. I'll find a way to stop on the time.
Yo, I never did tell you. You're a different kind of guy.
Don't be silly, Tom. I don't understand things. I'm trying to.
Thank you.
Tom, me and Joe. Don't cry anymore, Kitty.
I don't like this life.
Kitty, Joe got up from his chair, please. We don't know where town to get this toy. Please, music, listen.
That's me when I was 7.
Gee, you're pretty, Kitty.
Tom? Tom, when you were a little boy, what did you want to be?
What?
Do you remember when you were a little boy?
Yeah, I remember sometimes.
Well, what did you want to be?
Sometimes I want to be a locomotive engineer. Sometimes I want to be a policeman.
I wanted to be a great actress. Oh, Tom, didn't you ever want to be a doctor?
Yeah, sure. Now I remember. Sometimes.
I'm so glad. Because, see, I wanted to be a great actress and have a young doctor come to the theater and see me and fall in love with me. And send me flowers.
I would do that, Kitty.
I wouldn't know who it was. And then one day I would see him on the street and fall in love with him. I wouldn't know that he was the one who was in love with me. I dream about him all the time. I dream of being near him the rest of my life and having children that look like him. I wouldn't be an actress all the time, just until I met him and fell in love with him. After that, we'd take a train and go see the beautiful cities everywhere and the wonderful people. And whenever people were sad, we'd make them better again.
Talk to her. Be the wonderful young doctor she dreamed about but never got. Go ahead. Direct the ears of the world.
Oh, I don't know what to say.
Kitty! Oh, Kitty, where the hell are you, Kitty?
I'm looking for a sailor boy!
What's lost and beautiful, Lena? Where else?
Looking for a sailor boy!
You? No, not you. Kitty! Stink!
Don't you dare come to me that way, you pickpocket!
My room 21, where the hell is that room?
Go on, get up!
Talk! Who is it?
Here he is, number 21. A 1,000 apologies. I'll come back later.
You don't want Kitty!
Tom, no! You stay here with Kitty. I'm going down to the Union Square to hire an automobile. We'll ride to the Half Moon Bay. We'll have supper there. You and Kitty can dance.
Good. You mean you're going on there for me? You're not going to send me.
Dude, those are good.
Sunshine.
Very
You'll never know how glad I am to see you. Just to see you, I was afraid I'd never see you again. It was driving me crazy. I didn't want to leave. I know you told me before, but I can't help it, Elsie. I love you.
I know you love me, and I love you too. But don't you see? Love is impossible in this world.
No, maybe it isn't, Elsie.
No. Love is for the birds. Their wings to fly away on when it's time for flying. For tigers in the jungle, because they don't know their
rest.
They know our rest. Every night I watch over poor dying men. I hear them breathing, crying, talking in their sleep, crying for air and want your love, for mother and field and sunlight. We can never know love and goodness. We should know both.
Elsie, I love you.
You want to leave. I want to leave too. But where? Where can we escape our whole world?
Elsie, we'll find a place. All right, darling. Of course.
We'll go to a room in a cheap hotel and dream that the world is beautiful and I'll leave to above.
We're formerly models and magic.
don't like.
Nick, every once in a while, I catch myself being mean to them, hating on them, just because they're down and out, broken, hungry, sick or drunk. But then, when I'm with doctors at headquarters, I'm suddenly nice to them, trying to make an impression. What cool people I don't like? I feel disgusted. You know what? I'm going to quit. Quit out. I'm going to give up my behavior and the gadgets I go with. This is a good role. So why do they always want to make jokes for all the time?
No foundation.
What?
No foundation. No foundation.
I'll say there's no foundation.
All the way down the line.
All right. Is that all he ever says?
That's all he's been saying this week.
What is he anyway?
He's an Arab. Something like that.
No. I mean, what is he doing for a living?
What do you do for a living, brother?
Work. Work all my life. All my life, work. From small boy to old man, work. In old countries, work. In new countries, work. In New York, Pittsburgh, Detroit, Chicago, Imperial Valley, San Francisco, work. No bag, work. For what? Nothing. Three boys in old country, 20 years, not seen. Lost, dead. Who knows? What? What not? Nothing. No foundation. All the way down the line.
And what did he say last week?
Didn't say anything. Played the harmonica.
No, the country sounds like fun. It's 5,000 miles away.
Do you think you can play to that?
I want to sing. I can't sing.
You try and play to that. I will try to dance. Well, anyhow,
nice pre-born Czechoslovak. Lovely, lonely Czechoslovak. Oh, what kind of a place, pre-born, what? Pre-born!
What's the matter with him?
Drunk. Pre-born, joke.
Pre-born?
Who's pre-born?
He's a Czech. He's a Slav. He's a Czechoslovakian.
He's drunk.
Pre-born's a city in Czechoslovakia.
Oh. She was nicer, Joe.
Kitty Duval? One of the finest people in the world.
She was nice of you too. Hire an automobile and take us for a drive down the ocean front down to half the bay.
Those 3 hours were the most delightful, the most somber, and the most beautiful I have ever known.
Why, Joe?
Why? I'm a student, Tom. A student. I study all things. All. And when my study reveals something of beauty in a place, or in a person where by all one's own ugliness or death should prevail, and I know how full of goodness this life is, that's a truth I'll always seek to verify.
Are you sure?
Is it a drug or just nature or crazy?
Joe,
you won't get sore or anything.
What is it?
Yo, where do you get all that money from? You paid for the 2 bottles of champagne and 2 suppers at the Half Moon Bay restaurant. You moved Kitty out of the New York hotel around the corner to St. Francis Hotel Power Street. I saw you pay your rent, Joe. I saw you give her money for new clothes. Where do you get all that money, Joe? 3 years now and I've never asked.
Don't be a fool, Tom. Listen carefully. If anybody's got any money, or to throw away, you can be sure they stole it. And not from rich people who can spare it, but from poor people who can't. From their lives and from their dreams. I'm no exception. I earned the money I throw away. I stole it like everyone else does. I heard people get loafing around this way, I still earn money. The money itself earns more. I still hurt people. I don't know who they are or where they are. They probably feel worse than I already do. I've got a Christian conscience in a world that's got no conscience at all. I'll have money. I'll always have money as long as this world stays the way it is. I don't work. I don't make anything. I drink. I worked when I was a kid. I worked hard. I mean hard. People say you're supposed to enjoy living. I got tired. So? I decided to get even with the world.
Well, you can't enjoy living unless you work.
Unless you do something. Well, I don't do anything. I don't want to do anything anymore. There isn't anything I can do that won't make me feel unhappy. Because I can't do simple, good things. I haven't got the patience and I'm too smart. Money is the guiltiest thing in the world. It stinks. Now don't ever bother me about it again.
I didn't mean to make you feel bad, Joe.
Here. Take this gun outside and give it to some worthy hold-up man.
What's he saying?
You want to visit a honky-tonk. Well, this is a honky-tonk. Married for 28 years and she's still looking for adventure.
Do I have to give it to somebody?
Of course.
Can I take it back and get some for money?
Don't talk like a businessman, Tom. Take the gun outside and give it to somebody. It's a good gun, isn't it?
The man said it was, but how should I know who needs a gun?
Tom, you've seen good people who needed guns before, haven't you?
I don't remember. Joe, I might give it to the wrong kind of guy. Might do something crazy.
All right. Find someone myself. Take this money and go get me this week's Life, Liberty, Times, and 6 or 7 packages of chewing gum.
Life, Liberty, Time, and 6 or 7 packages of chewing gum. All that chewing gum, Joe? What kind?
I don't know. Any kind. Mix them up.
Licorice, too?
Licorice, by all means.
Juicy fruit?
Juicy fruit.
Tutti frutti?
Tutti. Is there such a gum?
I believe so.
You don't get tutti frutti. Get all the kinds. Get as many kinds as they're selling.
All right, Joe, so life, liberty, time, and all the different kinds of chewing gum.
Get some jelly beans, too, all the different colors.
Okay, Joe.
And the longest Panatella cigars you can find. 6 of them.
Panatella, got it.
Give a news kid a dollar.
Okay, Joe.
Give an old man a dollar.
Okay, Joe.
Give the Salvation Army people in the street a couple of dollars. Tell them to sing that song that goes, let the lower lights be burning, send a gleam across the way.
Let the lower lights be burning, send a gleam across the way. Got it.
Some poor dying, struggling seaman, you may rescue, you may save.
Okay, Joe, I got it. Life, liberty, time, all the different kinds of chewing gum. Dog for news kid, dog for the old man, dog for Salvation Army, Panatella cigar, let the lower lights be burning, send a gleam across the way.
It's absolutely insane.
You asked me to take you to Honky Tonk, this damn park hopkins. We are here in Honky Tonk. I can't help you if it's crazy. Do you want to go to a place where people aren't crazy?
No, not just yet.
Well, they'll be telling me every single minute that it's crazy.
You need
to be healthy, man. Presbyterian?
I attended a Presbyterian Sunday school.
Fond of singing?
On occasion. Have a drink?
Thanks.
Get a glass of some
air. Our Father's mercy. From the light of evermore unto us, He gives a giving of the light alone.
Barrel back in place.
Bangkok. And all you do is aim and fire.
All set?
Ready to kill.
Let me hold it.
Careful now, son. Don't cock it. Many men's lost an eye fooling with a loaded gun. Fellow I used to know named Danny Donovan lost an oath, ruined his whole life. Now, hold this firm, squeeze the trigger, don't snap, expose your aim.
Thanks, let's see if I can unload it.
Of course you can.
I'm mighty grateful. Always wanted to see one of these things up close. Is it really a good one?
It's a beauty, son.
Bang! Oh boy! There you are, Mick. Thought I couldn't do it, eh? Now watch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Oh boy, what a beautiful country. Okay, all that. 6 nickels. Took me a little while, but I finally did it. It's scientific, really. With a little skill, a man can make a modest living out of winning the marble games. Not that that's what I want to do. I just don't like the idea of anything getting the best of me. Not a machine, nor anything else. I myself am the kind of a person who makes up his mind to do something, then goes to work, and then does it. There's no other way a man can be a success at anything. See this letter? It doesn't stand for some idiot high school somewhere, it stands for me. Faroli, really Faroli. I'm an Assyrian. We have a history of 6 or 7 centuries old, I think, somewhere along those lines. Ever heard of Osma? Harold Osma? He owns an orchestra down in Fresno, and I've never seen you in my life. But I can tell from the clothes you're wearing and the company you're keeping that you're a man who looks every problem straight in the line and goes to work and then suddenly, I am that way myself. Well, it's been wonderful talking to nicer kind of people for a change. So long, chaps. I'll be seeing you. Goodbye, Lindy. You've got a good man here. So long, Nick. My God! For a while there, I didn't think that young Assyrian was going to do it. That fellow's got
something. Assyrian.
Next time. Get it up.
Yeah. Had a little trouble with the jelly people, so
take a look at it.
You got the jelly beans.
Save us up, save us up. Have some.
Thanks. I remember the first time I've ever had jelly beans. I was 6, or at the most 7. 7 or 8, Baltimore.
Have some, Tom.
Thanks, Joe.
Yeah. Tutti frutti, all right. Yep. Always wanted to see how many I could chew at once. Tell you what, Tom. I bet I can chew more at once than you can.
I'll referee.
All right.
All right. How many you got? Here it is. All right. Let Tom catch up with you.
Do you give him a musket $1? Yeah, sure.
What'd he say?
Thanks.
What sort of kid was he?
Little tail. Like a girl.
Easy to please?
Yeah.
Did you give an old man $1?
Mm-hmm.
What'd he say?
Thanks.
All right. How many you got in your mouth?
6.
All right. 7. 7 each.
Joe, why'd you move Kitty out of St. Francis Duncan?
Better woman than any of them tramp society dames that hang around that lobby.
Hey, do you think she'd be at home up there?
Maybe not, but after a while she'll get used to a nice break room, a bed for sleeping in, good clothes, good food. She'll be all right, huh?
But don't you think she'd be lonely out there with no one to talk to?
There isn't anyone, anywhere for her to talk to, except you.
Me, Jim?
That's you. By the grace of God, you're the other half of that girl. I'm not the angry woman that swaggers into this waterfront dive and shouts because the
world has kicked around. Anyone can act hurt. You belong to the little kid in Ohio. One dreamed of living. Not with her carcass for money so you can pay rent and buy her clothes and food. With all of her. I put her in that hotel so that she can have a chance to gather herself up again. She can't do that at the New York hotel. You saw what happened there. You talked to her like a whore.
13.
And after a while, she'd believe it, then. She wouldn't be able to remember.
Well?
People get lonely for misery, but I want her to stop being lonely for you. So she can come together the way she was supposed to from the very beginning. Any more licorice?
What, I guess we should do that in. We still got no business debate to prove.
Licorice used to be my favorite. Don't worry about her, Tom. She'll be all right. You only want to marry her, don't you?
Honest to God, Joe. Only, I haven't got the money.
Could you be a firefighter or something?
Nah. I could have been a man if I wasn't sore at it. But it has to do something that makes me hate it.
Well, you've got to figure out something to do that you won't mind doing very much.
I wish I could, Joe.
Tom, would you be embarrassed driving a truck?
Joe, I never thought of that. I'd like that. Just travels and highways and hotcakes and coffee and streams and daybreaks and sunsets.
There is poetry in it at that.
Joe, that's the kind of job I should be doing. Just look and smile and bust out laughing. Can Kitty come with me? Sometimes.
I don't know. Get me that phone. Can you drive a truck?
Joe, you know I can drive a truck or anything with more red wheels.
Here it is, Tuxedo 7900. Get me that number. Ask for Mr. Keith.
Hello? Hello, Mr. Keith?
Take that number to him out for a minute.
Mr. Keith. Mr. Keith.
Tell him to hold the line.
Hold the line, please.
Hey, give me a hand. Hello, Keith? Yeah, Joe. Yeah, don't worry about it. Hey, have you got a place for a good driver? Yeah, hold on, I don't know, I'll ask. You have a license?
No, but I can get one.
No, but he can get one easy enough. To help with the union, he'll join later. Tell him he's a vice president that drives for relaxation. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, oh, tonight, San Diego. Yeah, I don't see why not. Yeah. Sure, I'll send him over right away. Take a look at him. Thank you. Yeah, bye-bye.
What do you say, Joe?
He wants to take a look at you.
How'd I look?
Hold up your head. Up on your chest. How do you feel?
Fine.
You look fine, too. You went, huh? Now look. Have yourself a pleasant smoke. Give those slumbers one each.
What do you think you are doing?
Really, dear, I'd like to.
No, this is too much.
I'd really, really like to, dear.
Mother of five grown-up men, and she's still looking for a mess. No, I forbid it!
Ah, what's the matter with you? Why don't you leave her alone? What are you pushing your women around for all the time? Hey. Here's $10.
$10.
Yeah, he may want to get you to a truck tonight and drive you to San Diego.
Joe, I got it to Kitty.
I'll tell her.
Take care of her, will you, Joe? Tell her about me.
Yeah, I will. Get going.
Okay, Joe. Thank you, Joe.
Don't be silly.
Where the hell have you been? You've got to have some entertainment around here. Can't you see them blind people from uptown?
sent to come back at 10 for the second show.
Did I say that?
Yes, ma'am. That's exactly what you said.
Was the first show, right?
That wasn't a show. There was no one here to see it. How can it be a show if there's no one here to see it? People are afraid to come down to the waterfront.
Yeah, we went down to Pier 27. One of the longshoremen and the cop had a fight, and the cop hit him over the head with a blanket. We saw it happen, didn't
yes, we? Yes, we were standing there looking when that happened.
Anything else happened?
They was all talking.
A man with a big car came up and said that there was going to be a meeting right away, and they hoped to satisfy everybody and stop the strike.
Right away, tonight.
It's about time. Them cops are liable to get nervous and shoot somebody. Get back here, I want you to turn about for a while.
Yes, ma'am!
I'm gonna take a walk over to the pier. The society doesn't make up their mind yet.
Have something.
What do you think he's been pouring out of that bottle all this time? Water or something?
Chilled bottle.
I've got a dozen of them chilled. He's been drinking all night and all day here for a month now.
May we have
it? It's $6.
I think we can manage.
Hiya, Muffin.
I don't know.
Never in burlesque. We were just poor.
Sit down.
I tried other things.
Here's to you, Katerina Kornowska. Here's to you and Tom.
Where is Tom?
He's out getting a job tonight, driving a truck. He'll be back in a couple of days.
I told him I'd marry him.
I wanted to see him say goodbye.
He's too good for me. He's like a little boy and I'm... Too many things have happened to me.
You truly are one of the most innocent people in the world. Back to the hotel and wait for him.
That's what I mean. I can't stand being alone. I'm no good. I don't know what it is. I try very hard. I miss.
You really want to come back here?
I don't know. I'm not sure. Everything smells different. I don't know what to think or how to feel. I know I don't belong there. It's what I wanted my whole life, but it's too late. And I try to be happy about it, Joe, but all I can do is remember everything and cry.
I don't know what to tell you. I didn't mean to hurt you.
You haven't hurt me, Joe. You're the only person who's ever been good to me. I've never known anybody like you. You know, I'm not sure about love anymore, but I know that I love you. And I know that I love Tom.
And I love you, Katie Duvall.
He'll want babies. I know he will. I know. I will too, of course.
Tom's a baby himself. We'll be happy together. He wants you to ride in his truck. Tom's good for you. You're good for Tom.
Thank you.
foundation.
What?
No foundation.
No foundation? How do you figure? Nick,
where's Nick? She went for a walk, are you?
Harry!
Hey, you shut up!
What's your name, sister? Kitty Duval. What's it to you?
Now, don't give me any of your gutter lip. Just answer my question.
Go to hell, you.
Where do you live?
The New York Hotel, room 21.
Where do you work?
I'm not working just now. I'm looking for work.
What kind of work? What kind of work?
You can't talk to a lady that way in my presence.
It's okay, boys. I'll take care of this. What you say?
You have the right to hurt people. Who are you?
Your attitude is making the poor child say things that are not true.
Shut up, I say.
Well, are you going to stay for such insolence?
Are you?
I'll get a divorce. I'll start my life all over again. Come on, let's get out of here.
I'm an actress.
I see. What movies have I seen you in?
No, I was in burlesque.
You're a liar.
It's the truth!
Then, what are you doing here?
I came to see if I could get a job here.
Doing what?
Singing and dancing.
You can't sing or dance. What are you lying for?
I can't. I sing and dance in burlesque all over the country.
You're a liar.
You said lines, too.
You dance in burlesque?
Yes.
All right. Let's see what you did.
I can't. There's no music, and I haven't got the right clothes.
Oh, there's the music. You, put an angle in that photograph. Come on, put an angle in that photograph. All right. Get up on that stage, you little burlesque number. Get going now. Let's see you dance the way you did in burlesque all over the country.
She made her take off her clothes, and she got out the old man too.
What's going on?
Is this truck out there?
Yeah, what's happening?
He's going good.
Are you driving to San Diego?
Yeah.
Go, they're hurting the poor cop. Cop!
You can't hurt
him! Go on, kill him! Cop!
He's ready!
Get going. Take those books. Get dressed in the truck.
Thank you.
concerned. This is the only
I saved nuts to Europe.
Hey, Nick, something's wrong with the machine.
Give it a whack on the side.
Thanks. Somebody just got shot. How do you feel?
Never felt better in my life.
I shot someone once in San Francisco.
Shot her two times in 1939. I think it was in October. A woman named Glick or something like that. Couldn't stand the way she talked to people. Went up to my room and got my old pearl-handled revolver and waited for her on Pacific Street. Saw her walking and let her have it two times. Had to throw the beautiful revolver into the bay.
crowd.
Thank you.